Trailblazers, my name is Narin and let's dive into the lore and secrets of Honkai Star Rail. In the main story 2.1, we were presented with life story of Aventurine. Throughout the story, Sigonia, Afkin, and Gayatra are mentioned repeatedly. But what are they actually? In this video, we will discuss what is Sigonia, Afkin, and Katika are, and then who Gayatra is. So without further ado, let's begin. Let's start with what is Sigonia 6. Sigonia 6 is a desert planet with extremely harsh environment. It has little rain and frequent threats from space debris. There aren't many living there, and humans that live there are called Sigonians. They are divided into several nomadic tribes, with some of them already having a government system. Katika and Afkin are two of the many clans there. First, let's talk about the Afkin. In Sigonian's language, Afkin means honey. Afkin people have attractive facial features, beautiful eyes, and natural emotional intelligence. However, these traits make other people jealous. They start accusing and slandering them, calling them petty theft. As a result, Afkin's reputation becomes really bad, and people always get suspicious of them. Another interesting fact about Afkins is that they love fabrics with detailed patterns. They also love jewelry made from precious gemstones, especially turquoise meteorites. Now we know why Aventurine wears clothes like that. Next, we will talk about the Katika tribe. There is not much information about them, but they have a reputation for being the most ferocious of the Sigonian clans. Katika and Afkin have been enemies for centuries. Keep this in mind because we will discuss this more later. Now, we will talk about their goddess. Gayatra Triclops, also known as French Bios. I'm so sorry if I pronounce it wrong. Each tribe has its own belief about the goddess, and they don't follow the Aeon belief system. So, Gayatra is not an Aeon. The Afkins believe she is the goddess of fertility, travel, and trickery. She is portrayed as a left palm with three eyes. The Afkins worship their goddess only through spoken prayers. It's because they think fancy worship methods don't match her humble nature and just push them away from her. Beside of that, the Afkins also celebrate a festival called Kakava to mark the yearly rebirth of the goddess. They believe that everything on land is part of Gayatra's divine body. Each year, the body will perish and ascend as an aurora. Then the next day, the goddess will be reborn, and that is when they celebrate the Kakava festival. Alright, we already know what is Afkin and Katika, so let's talk about the conflict between them. One day, the IPC, specifically the Marketing Development Department, arrived in Sigonia to lead an operation to establish Sigonian sovereignty. It not only united the Sigonian clans, but also gave them a chance to expand into space. However, like I said before, the Afkin and Katika clans have been at each other's throats for centuries. Because of that, they were excluded from the sovereignty and banished to the desert. Moreover, the sovereignty gave the Afkin autonomy, which means they could govern themselves independently. So, if there were any conflict between the Afkins and Katikans, the sovereignty wouldn't be responsible. This banishment was known as the first Katika-Afkin extinction event. Years after the banishment, the Afkins and Katikans kept fighting. Eventually, the Katikans planned a mass genocide because of the grudge against them. The genocide was planned on the day of the Kakava festival. When the Afkins found out, they asked for help from the IPC and they agreed. However, even though they promised to help the Afkins, the IPC didn't show up that day. As a result, thousands of Afkins were killed or disappeared, leading to the end of the Afkin clan. This is called the second Katika Afkin extinction event. It is suspected that Aventurine is the only one left from the Afkins. The Afkin tribe story is so tragic and heartbreaking, and I think after knowing this, we love Aventurine more. For all who will pull for him, I wish you the best luck. Well, that's all for today. I hope this video is helpful. If you enjoy it, please give it a like and don't forget to subscribe for more Honkai Star Rail lore and secrets. See you at the next stop!